Hello everyone. Now let us try to solve a beam problem in the ANSYS. The figure on your screen is of cantilever beam with point load. The length of beam is 5 meter. It is a square cross section beam, 2 meter width and 2 meter height. A point load of 10 kilonewton is acting in the downward direction. Hank's modulus is 210 gigapascal and Poisson's ratio is 0.3. The moment of inertia for square cross section is given by BH cube by 12. So B is 2, H is 2. Under that condition, the moment of inertia will be 1.33. So for this problem, we need to draw the shear force and bending moment diagram. That we are going to do with the ANSYS. Open the software, Mechanical APDL 19.2. Go for preferences, select structural, click on OK. Go for preprocessor, element type. After that, go for this command prompt. There, we need to define the element type. So in the command prompt, we need to type ET, 1, element type, comma, beam 3. So beam 3 is the element type. Press enter. Again, go to the command prompt. There we need to define the real constants. So we need to type R, 1 real constants, R, 1, comma. Next we need to enter the cross section area of the beam, which is 4 meter square. Enter 4, comma. Next we need to enter the moment of inertia, which is 1.33, comma. And next we need to enter the height of the beam, which is 2 meter, and press enter. Next, go for material properties, material models, structural, linear, elastic, isotropic. Young's modulus is 210 gigapascal, 210 10 raised to 9 pascal, 210 e raised to 9, and Poisson's ratio is 0.3. Click on OK. Close this. Next, we need to create the nodes, and we need to create the element between the nodes. For that, go for modeling, create nodes in active coordinate system. The coordinate of this first node in x direction is 0. And the coordinate of this second node in x direction is 5. So we need to create the first node. So here you enter the node number as 1, and here you enter the value as 0. Since the coordinate of node 1 in x direction is 0, enter 0 and click on apply. Next, we need to create the second node, give the node number as 2. And here you enter the value as 5. Click on OK. Next, go for elements, auto numbered through nodes. Select first and second node. Click on OK. The element has been created between these two nodes. Now next we need to define the boundary conditions. That first node is fixed in all degrees of freedom, its displacement is 0. To define the boundary conditions, we need to go for loads. Define loads, apply, structural, displacement, select on nodes, and select this first node. Click on OK. Select all degrees of freedom, and here displacement value, you give it as 0. Click on OK. And the load is applied on the second node, which is of 10 kilonewton, which is acting in downward direction. So to apply the load on the second node, go for force moment on nodes, select second node, click on OK. So it is acting in negative y direction. The direction of force should be Fy, and the force value is minus 10,000. Click on OK. After this, go for solution, solve current load step, click on OK. Solution is done. Next, go for general post processor, element table, define table, add. So go for by sequence number and select SMISC. And in order to get the shear force and bending moment diagram, we need to define the element table. So we need to go for by sequence number and select SMISC, enter 2, click on apply. Again, go for by sequence number SMISC 8, click on apply. Again, go for by sequence number SMISC 6, apply. Again, go for by sequence number and select SMISC and enter 12. Click on OK. Close this. Go for plot results. Counter plot. Line element result. So in order to get the shear force diagram, at node I, it should be SMISC 2, and at node J, it should be SMISC 8. The element table at node I should be SMISC 2, and at node J, it should be SMISC 8. Click on OK. So this is the shear force diagram. Next, in order to get the bending moment diagram, go for line element results. Here you select for SMIC 6 and 12. Click on OK. So this is the shear force diagram. And in order to check the deflection of the beam, for that, go for list results, nodal solution, degrees of freedom solution, y component of displacement, click on OK. So here you can see the deflection of node 2 in y direction, which is minus 0.149 into 10 raised to minus 5 meter. Thank you.